If I, as a philosopher, can actually contribute something meaningful to a positive scientific or even a positive social development, that's wonderful. There are some things that are more important than others, and those are the ones we should be focused on.
Und mit denen sollte man sich beschäftigen.
My name is Vincent Müller. I do research on the philosophy and ethics of AI.
Artificial intelligence and robotics are digital technologies that have taken our world by storm. However, anyone who thinks about AI cannot avoid asking about the impact that this technology will have on humanity. Where and how do we want to promote the use of AI, and where do we need to implement strict rules and guidelines? Vincent Müller is a philosopher and pioneer of AI ethics, a field which is still a very young discipline.
I've spent many years between two stools. The philosophers said, what you're doing is obviously not really philosophy. And the AI experts said, obviously it's not really AI, which is of course true. So nobody wants to talk to me. It's a whole new experience for me that people say, ah, you know something about both philosophy and AI, that's wonderful. I can deal with formal and technical systems, and I can talk about philosophy. So what I do brings these two things together.
Müller is a bridge builder and networker. He succeeds in looking at progress from different perspectives in order to examine the influences of AI on society. Central to this is the analytical examination of normative and conceptual questions. For abstract concepts such as freedom, knowledge, good and evil should not only be considered from a human perspective. They should be transferable to any system, be it an ant, computer systems, or humans. For example, what would it mean to program an AI with the ability to form free will? What does free will even mean?
One key question is whether a technically successful AI and a good AI are the same thing. And the answer is clearly no. This is precisely the problem in AI ethics, trying to bring these two things together, what is actually done technically and what would make sense for our society.
The path to finding his answers now leads him to the Friedrich Alexander University in Erlangen. Here he can contribute his expertise in a variety of ways and thus advance different research areas. Aspects of data ethics or human-robot interaction are equally relevant as the ethical evaluation of AI systems. In other words, whether they are socially acceptable. Topics like these arise through the cooperation with developers and scientists.
I found out that the AI experts have very fundamental questions that are actually philosophical questions. So I said, ah, maybe I could contribute something here. It's not that I go out and tell the AI experts what the deal is. Instead, we work on this problem together. So it's not just an applied philosophy that I have in my pocket to apply to an area, but a change to the philosophy itself. That's the only way to create a change in AI.
Humans are the inspiration for AI. By understanding how humans solve problems, AI can be created to be more successful. But conversely, how does AI affect humans? Technological developments change humans in very different ways. They influence our self-image and the way we think. But why does AI come closer to us and affect us more than other technologies?
To me, a certain fear of AI is not only understandable, but also rationally justified. We should be worried about what it will do to our society. There is an extra aspect to AI, which is that artificial intelligence concerns precisely what makes humans special, namely human intelligence. And now suddenly a technology comes along that also has exactly this quality that is so central to us. And perhaps it has even more of it than we do. And that, of course, is a threat. Now we have machines with all these capabilities, and they're more intelligent. That should trouble us.
To counteract these concerns and promote a humane AI, transparency is needed, as well as control and a clear ethical compass. As a Humboldt professor, he will therefore co-found the Center for Philosophy and AI Research in Erlangen. It will act as an international hub for AI philosophy. He will also contribute his expertise beyond the university's borders by establishing collaborations with institutes such as the Fraunhofer Institute for Integrated Circuits. The development of trustworthy AI systems is also of top priority there.
As far as I know, it's a completely new development that we already think about what effects we hope a technology will have in the early stages of its creation. Normally, we do this when it's already too late. From this experience, we now realize we have a new technology that will certainly radically change society. We should have no illusions about that at all. And now we should really start thinking about the direction this should take.